Sunday setup time, guys. So right now we're headed to church. We're a little late. I mean, church started a minute ago, but we'll be there in like a couple minutes. And the girls have their beautiful sunshine dresses. I call them sunshine dresses because they have yellow flowers on them. Yellow daisies, yellow and white. That's right, and daddy. And so, yeah, we just decided to come to church this morning, and then we haven't eaten anything. So there's actually a Starbucks inside of our church. So I was gonna get the girls like a muffin from Starbucks, and I didn't even get to have my coffee, so I might order myself a coffee from Starbucks just with heavy cream, and I can't add my MCT oil, that's the thing, but they have Kerrygold butter at Starbucks, which is helpful, so I can just add the Kerrygold butter to it. But yeah, we're headed to church, and so today I think we're gonna do the norm. I gotta pick out the girls' clothes. We may do something with the girls later on today. Yesterday we had a super long day. We all slept in today. We were gone from the house from 11 a.m. to like 9 o'clock at night. So, I don't know, we may do something with the girls later, but and then I gotta cook, you know, all the huge. So make sure you download my free Sunday setup checklist so you can see what I do every week, and then you can create your own Sunday setup checklist as well. There's room for you to create your own there with that free download, but and the link is in the description box. So all right, let's get to church. Awesome service. It was all about the Holy Spirit, how the Holy Spirit convicts you. I mean, really spoke to my heart. How the Holy Spirit speaks to you, and just it was really, really good. I'm gonna insert a little snippet here of my favorite part, and I will leave a link for the full sermon in the description box. Not very long, so maybe about 30, 45 minutes, but something really great to listen to.
Perhaps if you're sitting here saying, okay, I wanna hear from God, the first thing you might need to do is go find 5 minutes this week. Go get yourself in a back bedroom, shut the door, close your eyes, take 10, 15 minutes and sit there and say, God, is there anything I'm doing that makes you unhappy? And the first thing he brings to mind is probably the first place that you should attend to. But the other side is true as well. For some of us, you don't need to go in that bedroom. You already know what God's gonna say. See, if you've walked with Jesus for any amount of time, the sins that are left in your life are typically the sins that you like. And every time you pray, the Holy Spirit won't stop talking about that sin that's destroying you. And so what you do is you keep him at an arm's distance because you're sick of hearing about it. And you ignore the Holy Spirit because you're sick of hearing about it. Listen, if you ignore the voice of conviction, his voice will grow quieter and smaller in your life. But if when the Holy Spirit speaks conviction into your life, if you attend to it, his voice will grow in prominence in your life. The first thing the Holy Spirit wants to do is to convict us, to convince us of our need for Jesus and our need to transform. The second voice that the Holy Spirit will bring. See, the Holy Spirit will also guide us. If you attend to his voice of conviction, the Holy Spirit will also guide you. And he will guide you from my agenda to God's agenda. He will guide you from my agenda to God's agenda. Now, we all know what agendas are, hopefully. If you've been to a meeting, usually you have an agenda. Here's the 5 things I'm gonna cover in the meeting. I have an agenda for my life. I look in the future and sort of think, this is the direction I hope my life goes. I have an agenda for my kids. We all have agendas. Did you know that God has an agenda? It's an interesting thought, isn't it? I think God has an agenda, and he's been working out his agenda for all of time. And God wants to get us on his agenda. He wants to invite us into what he's doing in this world. See, he wants to guide our decision-making so that the decisions we make get us closer to what he's doing. He cares about your decisions in finances and in relationships and in career and in marriage. He cares about those decisions. He doesn't want us to waste our life. He wants to actually give us insider information about what we should be doing with our life. And for most of us, when you hear how to hear the voice of God, this is what you're thinking about. God, give me the big decision stuff. Who do I marry? What job do I take? Do I sell my house? Do I move? Do I make this big purchase? But again, you'll never hear the guiding voice of the Holy Spirit until you attend to the convicting voice of the Holy Spirit.
And I ran into one of my subscribers while I was here, Belle. Hi, Belle. It was so nice meeting you. It kind of caught me off guard because at first I thought she was with the lady I was talking with, but then she was like, I watch your YouTube videos, and I was like, oh my gosh, hi. So nice meeting you. So hi, and thank you for watching. But yeah, the sermon was really, really good. I wrote down a little bit about the Holy Spirit, how it convicts you, it guides you, it empowers you. It empowers you to live as a missionary for Jesus as opposed to just for yourself. I mean, it was just really, really good. So I highly encourage you guys to listen to it. But we're gonna stop by my parents' house to say hi because they don't live too far from here, really quick. And then I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna take some chicken out. I got my meal plan for the week already. Yes, baby. And so I got to take some chicken out to cook for tonight, pick out the girls' clothes. I don't have to do their hair, praise the Lord. It's the last week of them going to daycare, and then they'll be going to school. I mean, Zara starts school in 1 week. So yeah, by the time you watch this, she'll probably be in school. So all right, so we're back home. The girls are now straightening up right now. They are putting all the shoes away because the shoes and our little walkway here, they just get out of hand. They get out of hand. So they are putting the shoes away and I am getting ready to make them lunch. Ava wants just some leftover mac and cheese. Zara just wants some fruit, I think, and some pepperoni. So we're gonna have that. Then we're gonna have learning time and then we're taking them to the pool. That's their incentive today. You listen, you do your work, we get to go swimming. Me, on the other hand, while they're eating their lunch, I'm gonna go upstairs, start their laundry and pick out their clothes and then go from there. All right, I'm about to get this load of laundry in here. And you know what? I'm not even gonna pick the girls' clothes out because lately they've just been in this mood where they want to pick out their own clothes, and I let them pick out their clothes for daycare, and Charles just lets them wear anything they want to wear. So when I go and pick them up, they just look crazy. So I'm letting them do this for one more week, and then when school starts, it's gonna be back to wearing the things that I pick out. So at least I don't have to do that today. So I'm going to, like I said, wash these clothes and then get ready to do some learning. So right now the girls are doing their looming and I'm laying their stuff out. And my mother-in-law is a teacher, a second grade teacher. So she sends me so much stuff all the time. And I'm sorry, I don't know where these are from Lakeshore. These are from Lakeshore Learning. It's a website. I'll leave a link in the description box. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna leave these out. This is for Ava, these picture cards. And it's a picture, she'll say, this is a hat. And I'll say, well, how do you spell hat? And I'll have her go, huh, huh, it's an H. And then she finds a letter and puts it on here, like so. Now, I don't let her dig through the letters like this because it's just distracting and it'll turn into a game for her just playing with the letters. And I want her to focus on the right letter for the card. So I'll lay out the right letters that she needs and mix the cards up. And then she has to decide what goes where. So it's like hat, it's really easy, box, things that, CBC words that she can sound out. So that's one game, hands-on. I'm still working on writing with her, and this is a really good book that I really like. I cannot remember, oh, I got this off of Amazon. It'll be linked in my Amazon store in the description box. But this really gets her ready for writing, better control of the pencil. So she'll do a page from there. Her read, she knows these Dolch words. I love this list of Dolch words because they're in order of frequency and by grade. You can get it off this website right here, dolchword.net. Print it out for free. And Zara knows all of these, but I always review them with her from time to time just to make sure. Right now we're working on these two columns with Ava. She knows most of these, and then we work on these. And then sometimes I even, the ones that she doesn't know, like that have the star next to it, I'll have her write, and that really helps as well. And then she has a book she needs to read called Sharing Day. Then this exercise is where she takes a dry eraser marker and she'll circle the picture that starts with the right letter. So I'll say, okay, here's a letter F. Which one of these pictures starts with an F? And I'll go flower, ladybug, whale, you know? And so, and then she decides and she'll circle. And then the last thing, and then also, these are just CVC practice words. She'll go pop. I really like to have like little dot underneath here. I think I printed this for free off of Teachers Pay Teachers. I can't remember the name of the store, but you can honestly make this yourself. It's not hard. You can print it out. Then the last activity is math. I mixed up, sorry, my husband's shredding in the other room, but I mixed up the numbers 1 to 20. So I'll call out a number like the number 19. Where's the number 19? And then she'll take the manipulative here and put it on top of the number 19.
Again, hands-on, something quick and simple and easy. This is a lot of things. I don't know if she'll get through all of these. We'll try to get through as much as she can, but it's something fun and, like, again, something that she likes to do. She's really good at all three of these things, so I try to encourage her and make sure to put things in here that she's really good at, because if you give her something that she's not good at, it kind of discourages her, and then she doesn't want to learn at all. So it's a good to have a healthy mix of the things that she's good at. For Zara, we're doing place value. So what we do is, this is my husband or myself will come in here. This is her math journal. I'll write the name. I will say, what number is that? Because it's hard for her sometimes if she doesn't have this chart to tell me what number it is. I'll say, what number is that? She'll tell me the number and then write it in here in the right place value, and then put the right number of tens, hundreds, and thousands in there. I think this was free from JDA's website. I'll leave a link in the description box. So we'll do that. We're doing time, still focusing on time. It's something really easy. I typically like to do the harder thing first, because if I, one harder thing for Zara first, because if I give her, let her do the easy things first, so she'll play around and then not feel like doing the harder thing. The harder thing at the end. So I always like try to do reading first with Zara. So we're gonna read two pages out of here, and then time and place value. And I think we're gonna do a spelling book, a page out of her spelling book, and also some writing in her writing journal. I like to just practice words, practice writing in her writing journal, just to keep her on top of her writing. Good. What's that? No, that's a B.
Big.
Good. Keep going.
I have to do this one.
Mm-hmm. What's that say?
Come.
Mm-hmm.
Blue. Red.
Her. Where?
Where? Like, where your underwear?
That's, no. Like, where are you?
Like, where is your biggest?
That's right. Keep going. Okay, go ahead. Where are we at? Where? This one. Right, this one. Okay. Did you say this one? What's that say? So now, instead of, I want her to move on to the next thing, but she wants to read another column, so I just go with the flow with her. Okay, so you want to write? Okay, we can do that. You'd rather do that next? Let's do that. What's that say?
How do you do a capital
pop.
R?
Pop.
Good. What's that say?
Can I tell Pop that?
Yeah, you can tell Pop. Go ahead. What's the next
there
one?
You go.
Can I just go show him today?
Later on, okay? We can FaceTime him. Go ahead.
G.
J.
Gum.
Very good. What's next? Let's do the first one together. When you only see three numbers, that means we use three boxes. And we start right here. So it's 946. Okay? When there's only three numbers, it's in the hundreds.
I just say 46.
You did, but you said 9,046. 9,046 looks like this. Let me erase this. 9,046. This is 9,046 because there's four numbers here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. All right.
Yeah. Ooh, go A B.
Good job, Zara. Now, how does that look with these cards here? Good job, Ava. Zara's placing out her cards. Can I have her like say it out? Wow. And this one, what letter is that?
H.
What number? What letter?
H.
Good. And what's that?
G.
Good. And what's this one?
I.
Oh, very good. What is this, Ava? What's a picture that a picture of? And what letter starts with, what letter, don't turn it over, but what letter starts with hat? Which one of those letters right there?
Daddy.
Which one of these letters starts with hat? Put the letter on top.
There you go.
Good job, girl. Let's do the next one. See if you're right. Good job, Zara. What does it say? What does it say? What number is this?
Right here. All right. No.
What number does it say?
All right. So what letter do you need?
Box.
Okay.
100.
Box.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Ooh,
that's right. Let's count them. 100, 200.
There 1, you go.
Mm-hmm.
10. 200.
Mm-hmm. Okay, write it.
There you go.
Good. Okay, put your cards out.
20, so you.
Good reading, Ava.
What?
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 Mm-hmm.
No. Mm-hmm. Is 4,321.
Yay. Good job, Ava. Good job, Zara. That was a rough learning session with Zara. I'm noticing that if she doesn't know something, she kind of gets discouraged, and then she doesn't want me to, she like kind of wants to give up and or she'll start crying. But she only does it for me. She doesn't do it for her teacher at school. She doesn't do it for her teacher at daycare. It's only for me. So I feel like it's like an attention thing. So I let her take a break, and I'll say, you can go upstairs. And then when you're ready to learn more, it's not like she's getting in trouble, but I just want her attitude to change. So sometimes she just needs a break to like, you know, go breathe it out or go think about something else and then come back in. Because the tears and stuff, it's like, I feel like it's an act that she puts on. So I'm still, this is like a new thing that she just started doing, and it's like, I just don't know where it's coming from. Again, I think it's an attention thing. Because her teacher at daycare, she doesn't do that with. And she doesn't do it with her teacher at school. So, or she doesn't do it with her, she didn't do it with her kindergarten teacher either. So I'm still working on it. She can't always have the attention. Now that Ava's in here learning, she like feels like she wants the attention of both me and her dad at the same time, and that I can't do that when they're both in here learning. So I'm still trying to do different techniques and stuff and see where we can go with that, because she knows the information. It's just like, then she'll act like she doesn't on purpose for attention. I don't know. Leave a comment down below if you experience any of that, or if you're a homeschooling mom and you deal with that, because I noticed like, I never see any homeschooling videos that show how you actually teach your child and what you do when you have resistance. Like, I want to see it, you know? And I definitely get resistance a lot from both of them, you know? It just depends on what kind of mood they're in, you know? So I'm still working on it. But I never want to give up. They're my children. I'm never going to give up, you know, on their learning. So anyway, now they did their work, so they got their stickers on their chart. We do like a reward system. When they get all the stickers on their chart, then I'll give them like $10, and they can decide how they want to spend their $10. They can save. So I encourage them to save some and then spend some. And they can only spend like what they could afford, you know? So now we're gonna get ready to take them swimming at the pool. We are getting ready to head to the pool. The girls are using their new goggles. Right, girls? Looks so cute. Let's go have some fun and burn some energy. Hey y'all, so we are home. I'm really pooped. We had a really good time at the pool. I got in a workout, I did some laps, the kids swam quite a bit, and now I'm like really pooped. I really don't feel like cooking, but I gotta do what I gotta do. But all of our hair is washed, we're all showered, had to wash and condition the girls' hair to get the chlorine out. So it's like 8 o'clock, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I really feel like cooking. I really don't. Let me see if the chicken's thawed. It's thawed. What is this? Wait a minute. So earlier today, I took this out of the freezer to thaw out. I thought this was chicken breast. Well, guess what? They're drums. I'm like, oh, it takes forever to cook these. We usually grill these. Whenever I thaw these out, it's to grill, not to like. I was just gonna pan fry some chicken breasts, you know. I was gonna thin them out and then just pan fry it with some seasoning on it. Now, what are we gonna do? So because of my piss poor planning, I'm having a baby wedge salad and some lemon pepper wings. I'll show you the wings when I get back. Oh, I forgot to add my bacon. Totally didn't mean to take those out. So good thing there's a good to eat out. And here are my lemon pepper wings. Okay, so I'm done eating. This resulted from the pool. This is our towels and our bathing suits and stuff. So you gotta wash that. Right now I'm washing my linens and the girl stuff dried. And I have two loads to fold and put away tonight. Well, at least I'll fold one load tonight. I commit myself to one load to fold tonight. Then I need to put that load away. Come on, it's time to go to bed. Okay. First of all, you're tired. You're melting. It's Ava. Give me the blanket. We're having prayer time now. Okay? Thank you. It's prayer time. All right, y'all. So the girls are in the bed and they're overly tired, especially Ava. She's super cranky. But we had prayer and then they're actually asleep already. It's been like 5 minutes. So I'm going to try to fold a load and put that load away. Then I'm going to hit the bed too. We had a really jam-packed weekend. It was really fun, but we did a lot over the weekend. We spent a lot of time together and went and did different things outside of the home. So it was good. I'm glad we were able to go swimming with them. That was always fun. So that's it. What did you guys do this past Sunday? Are you ready for school, or are your routines going to change when school starts? I know ours will change. It'll get a lot busier. I'll have to go back to packing lunches and all that stuff. So, but I'm looking forward to it. But yeah, leave a comment down below and let me know what you did this past Sunday and how your routine is going to change for back to school. If you haven't seen my latest back to school haul, you can tap this eye right here. But we're pretty much set. We're pretty much ready. This up and coming week, we'll be meeting her teacher, and I'm really excited about that. So, but thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, you can tap my picture up above, and you can also check out my previous video right over here and all of my social media platforms, all listed down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.